I would now like to move on to the next petition for debate, which is being presented by Jasmine from Parsons. And Jasmine, if you would like to have 5 minutes to speak and present your petition, well, thank you very much.
Thank you. Well, I don't intend to be railroaded or shoved up like you did, Councillor Sanger. Toads! God, the reason why we're here today is because the bloody Toads are doing this to all the residents in this borough. And we don't like it, right? Pigs, green, chopping, they're taking into public money, even now, getting rid of public housing. This represents investors, builders, and all the other those tow banks who are deliberately getting rid of the social housing.
You're very proud of. You're bringing that over.
recover for a bit first. I think I should give Councillor Sandra possibly a right to reply before taking out questions.
Mr. Mayor, the facts of the matter are that my personal involvement with the West Hendon regeneration scheme finished 12 years ago.
Oh, how convenient.
12 years ago, my personal involvement. I do recall, however, when I came down to West Hendon, people down there telling me over and over again that the estate and their homes were not fit to live in. That is why we worked so hard.
Would you like to ask a question, please?
Will the Speaker acknowledge that when we went out to a ballot of all the residents of West Hendon, there was an overwhelming majority of people who supported the regeneration of
which it is not now, it's a development, it is a
£3.
Right, I'll answer that for you. In fact, Metropolitan can answer that for you because they went round and collected those voting slips and actually helped people to fill them in. That was how busy that was. Independent, my backside. You deliberately rigged it. We said no to you. You only finally sold it with the pledge. You could get it through the trailway. So, walking around, you asked a few people, I told you no, I spoke up against you no, and the majority of people who was in that meeting said no, but you still went forward with the ballot, and with the ballot papers, the only thing that said that I was in favour of it was, yes, we'd like a new home, yes, because you're not doing anything here anyway. All the people who were against it, they wrote volumes of facts why they didn't want it in. And the fact is that every single one of those facts is true. You lied to us.
Right, can we have a question from Labour side now?
Quick statement. When you vote on a set of pledges, you expect the pledges to be kept. Yes. My question is, Mr. Parsons, is do you think it's acceptable that the West Hendon Estate proposal started with over 500 council homes to be built, and it ended up with just 219, given that we practically gave the land away? And would you also agree that the basic starting points for any regeneration proposal in this borough should be like-for-like replacement, no loss of social housing units?
I totally agree, and that was exactly what was pledged. That's what Councillor Brian Salinger signed up to, and he kept telling us, like for like, every single resident would get a home on that estate. Every single resident is exact words and what is written down, and you should be honouring that, not ignoring us.
Councillor John Hart.
I'm intrigued by your reference to a war memorial which has disappeared. If you could let me have details, I'd be very grateful.
Yeah, I can do that.
I'm a member of the Barnet War Memorial Association. I've never heard of it.
Well, there was one.
What?
Well, yes, we can do that. The stone cross actually disappeared in the early 1970s because there was residents that actually noted that it was on the car park, which then got moved. And we don't know where that's gone, but we do have pictures. And Theresa went and investigated it in great detail, and we know that the services was held there every year for a good number of years, and there's also held on the back part as well, where they're building the sinking tower of West Hendon, which we twinned with the Leaning Tower. Okay.
Thank you very much for all the questions. I can't see any more questions, so we're going to move on to the reply, which is... No, sorry, I've already moved on now. That came in after. The right to reply, which is Dan. Try and look out for every member if they've got their hand. I miss you occasionally, but you have to let me know. I was scanning backwards and forwards to find him.
Okay, I'm going to
bounce to Thomas, because otherwise we are going to run out of time and he won't have a chance to reply. Thank you.
Mr. Mayor, if I can, I'd like to welcome the submission of this petition, and as we've done before it, we should take note of the number of signatures from Barnet residents. I thank the speaker today for that very forceful contribution to tonight's debate. I just want to clear up the facts about the number of houses that are going to be built, the social rent houses. A paper that was tabled at the request of Councillor Cook states that there will be 258 social rented units in... That is a net reduction of 220, and we've been quite open about that. But what people forget, is that there's going to be an increase of 285 low-cost ownership properties. Request 1 and 2 regarding the secure tenancies. We're so far down the road with this now, we can't negotiate the terms. And what points 1 and 2 are asking is completely unrealistic. We can't negotiate the terms.
Yes, you can.
And we're building there now. You have a complete wall. So points 1 and 2 are unrealistic. Point 3 regarding the freedom of information, I'll ask the FOI team to take that into consideration along with statutory guidelines for FOIs. That's fine, we'll get that to them. But on point 4, and as I say, we can't hand out secure tenancies anymore, flexible tenancies. We actually have a policy and we have to keep within it. Now, housing officers are working very hard. Those residents who do have to move, and as this week's way, residents who moved in after regeneration was announced were informed that this is a temporary tenancy. This is a temporary situation.
Now, unfortunately, the development
did take longer than the plan to get going. And that was because of the recession. Of the housing crisis as well, and the house builders. So the problem is out of Barnet's control. But as soon as the market
$92 million
we've gone with this as quickly as we can. Now, Mr. Mayor, of the 70 non-secure tenants who have to be rehoused, only three have moved out of the borough, and the petition refers to people who have been shoved out of London. That is not the case. Three have moved out of the borough, and they willingly did so. And we tried very, very hard about it to rehouse tenants as close as they can to where they originally lived. We accept, with links to schools and work, employment, support networks, we accept that people would like to live, obviously, where they lived previously. So, Mr. Mayor, that's the problem with the petition. I've already touched on the overall net increase of 65 affordable houses. We debated this matter numerous times at committee and as chamber. I have not yet heard a compelling case to change the course that we're going to do. Mr. Mayor, we will continue with the policy.
Thank you very much. I'd like to thank the members for participating in that debate, and also thank the petitioner for the time and effort in bringing this petition to this council chamber and for the debate that ensued. I would just like to ask Council that this petition is noted. Thank you. Thank you very much.
I have 30,000 lines on it, and don't dismiss it, mate, because it's going further.
Right, we're going to move on to item 11.1, which is a referral from Community Leadership Committee, 24th of June 2015, Faith Covenant and Charter for the Voluntary Sectors. I call upon Councillor David Longstaff to move a session of adoption by amendment.